The following program is presented by the Diocese of Venice in Florida. The Diocese of Venice in Florida presents the Mass.
This morning, the TV Mass comes to you from Santa Maria Chapel on the campus of Epiphany Cathedral Catholic School in Venice, Florida.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, it's a pleasure to be with you on the sixth Sunday in the Easter season. It's not only that, though, it's Mother's Day. And we take this opportunity to extend greetings and blessings to all mothers and grandmothers who may tune in to this Mass broadcast. Also, we remember all of us, our mothers, living or deceased, in our prayers this day, and recall all who are mothers, the vocation they've been given, the good they have done. With that in mind, let us take a few moments as we acknowledge our sins in preparation for this holy sacrifice of the Mass. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him, and falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up, I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so also I love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friend. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I call you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Once again, as I begin this homily, I wish to extend to all mothers who may be tuned in a very blessed and happy Mother's Day. Certainly we appreciate, and that's a trite word in this case, but the love that is given and has been given to each one of us by our own mothers. The discourse we heard in the Gospel today from John is called the Shepherd's Discourse. And that line that Christ gives to you and to me when he says, "Love one another as I have loved you." Precisely in this line, we find, in a sense, the foundation to the entire Christian faith, really, certainly to living out Christian life. Christ himself is that foundation of the faith. But then his advice of how we are to live our life, we find it today. And certainly I think there's, in trying to reflect upon what is that love that the Lord is calling forth from you and from me, it is the love of a mother that we felt in our own lives, that we see around us daily, mothers making a sacrifice for their children, being totally selfless. That's what Christ was talking about, that model, that witness, that really his own mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary, showed us all as she stood before the cross on which hung her son. So that example of a mother's love, you know, because sometimes love can be an abstract thing to us. Christ is being very precise here and talking about how we should love one another. And we need to look upon the cross, you and I do, to look upon it in faith. And in so doing, see what God has revealed. See God revealed, but also what he has revealed in his Son. A love that is totally self-giving. It's giving for others' good. And this is what you and I are called to do, to have a selfless love. Christ tells us this is the type of love that you and I are to practice. It's difficult for us at times to do it. Why? We are sinners. Jesus Christ was not. So that kind of, that difference. And we have to live, what could we say, live for God by obeying God's commandments. Christ tells us that clearly. We need God's help to love others in this selfless, and no matter what someone does to you, says about you, gossips about you, whatever it might be, to turn back in love on our part. That's what we heard in this gospel today. To produce the fruit of love, we have to remain, should we say, on the vine and allow ourselves to be pruned by the Father. Pruned so we too can produce that love, that example, that witness. If we are to love others as God does, we need to remain, so to sense, in communion with Christ. We need to remain part of that body of Christ. And through activities such as prayer, sacraments, works of penance, you and I evidence that love toward Christ and toward others. And it's through these and other spiritual kind of ways that we open ourselves to that grace that we need from God to live a life that truly loves others. And why do we do this? We have to die to ourselves, really, in witnessing this love, in overcoming our sinfulness, and become ever more conformed to the Father's will. May each of us be given the grace needed to live that life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Let us now stand and join together in our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. During this month dedicated to our Mother Mary, let us together ask her intercession for our prayers and petitions.
For Pope Francis, Bishop Duane, all bishops and priests, may they guard the Lord's flock with patient love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Holy Mother Church, that she always be guided by the intercession of the Blessed Virgin. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers and grandmothers, may they come to know the Blessed Virgin as both model and protector, and may we give thanks for their endless love and care. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all affected by the coronavirus pandemic, may they feel the presence of comfort of Christ, the divine physician. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, especially those we have known and loved, may God bring them into the joy of his heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, hear the spoken and the unspoken prayers in our hearts. We do ask this, as always, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Blessed be the Lord God of all creation. For your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which earth has given you, and the goodness of God, that we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have this wine to offer, the fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us a spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offering, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
In his arms, holding them.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Hail, Holy Queen.
Thank you for watching TV Mass. The TV Mass is made possible because of contributions from viewers like you. To make a contribution to TV Mass, please send a check to the Diocese of Venice, care of TV Mass, 1000 Pinebrook Road, Venice, Florida, 34285. And you can view this Mass or previous Masses on the Diocese of Venice website. Visit dioceseofvenice.org and scroll down to the Televised Mass button.